When I was a kid, The Brady Bunch was just one of those shows that always seemed to be on TV. I wasn't the show's biggest fan. My favorites were Star Trek, Batman, Leave It to Beaver, and Andy Griffith. But that said, I always found my half-hour visits with the Brady family to be a really pleasant experience. And while all of the cast members were great, they really were, I have to admit that I thought that the kids were the best. Especially the young actresses who played Carol Brady's daughters. Yep, they were all a bunch of cuties, especially that Marcia Brady. Oops, I mean Maureen McCormick. Over the years, I have to admit that I've followed her career and always rooted for her success. And while Maureen went through a rough patch after the Brady Bunch went off the air, I've got to say that this lady has really pulled her life together. A few months back, I stumbled across this article over on the website Showbiz Cheat Sheet. In it, author Melissa Mitis writes that during the final season of The Brady Bunch, Maureen found a way to quietly rebel against the show's sugary sweet storylines. You see, while other shows were dealing with trending topics of the day, The Brady Bunch seemed determined to present an alternate reality where none of the era's top headlines seemed to affect the family. So how exactly did Maureen quietly demonstrate her dissatisfaction? Well, let me actually share an excerpt from Maureen's book, Here's the Story. In it, she writes, "I rebelled quietly by taping a show without wearing a bra. I convinced Eve to go braless, too. It was also our subtle way of telling the producers that we were too old for the same old stuff. So from what I can tell, this Brady Girls Go Wild moment only occurred on one or two episodes during that final season of the show. Upon noticing what was going on, show producer Lloyd Schwartz wisely chose not to make a big deal out of it. He didn't confront Maureen or Eve about their on-set act of defiance publicly. Instead, Lloyd made a point of visiting with both of the girls each morning, and he didn't say anything about their choice of wardrobe or lack thereof. Instead, while chatting, Lloyd would just place his hand on their backs to make sure that the girls had made the right decision. He didn't do this in a creepy way, but in the same way that a father would. I say that because, really, Lloyd Schwartz is a heck of a nice guy. It's important for me to say that this was a man who really cared about the cast. After the show ended, when Maureen was struggling mightily to get clean and revive her career, he opened up his home to her, and it became a safe haven, a sanctuary of sorts that allowed Maureen to really clear her head. Another showbiz giant who was hugely influential to Maureen was the late, great Ed Asner. Maureen loved watching Ed on the Mary Tyler Moore Show, and when she got an offer to work with him on the dramatic spin-off Lou Grant, she jumped at the chance. Her experience on that show was bolstered by Ed's kind and giving nature. There was an article published by The Hollywood Reporter just after Ed died earlier this year, where Maureen recalled just how much Ed wanted her to be successful as a dramatic actress. Alright, now it's your turn. Please share your memories in the comments section, and while you're at it, I'd love a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and I would be honored if you would consider subscribing to my channel. I talk about music, movies, and mostly television from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.